Hey guys, in this video I wanted to go over importance sampling with an example and some R code. And importance sampling is a type of Monte Carlo method. You usually use it to estimate some moment of a distribution. So you have a random variable x and it has some distribution, and usually you want to estimate some property of the distribution. So usually that's going to be, you want to estimate maybe the mean, or you want to know the variance of x. So some property from a target distribution, and this is one Monte Carlo method of getting those estimators. So importance sampling, which is sometimes abbreviated IS, is a simple extension of the idea of naive Monte Carlo. The idea with naive Monte Carlo is x, your random variable, is distributed pi x, where pi x is some target distribution. And if you wanted to estimate, for example, the mean of either x or a function of x, so let's say the expected value of h of x, so h of x is just a function of the random variable x. If you wanted to find the expected value, which is the mean, with naive Monte Carlo, we just know that this would be equal to the integral of h of x times pi of x dx. So if this is true, you can just estimate mu by getting the sample mean. So you can do resampling using Monte Carlo methods and then get the sample mean of a sample that you created, and that would give you an estimate of your mean, and you can also find the standard error or an estimate of the variance as well. So that's naive Monte Carlo, and that's one way of doing Monte Carlo methods to get information from a target distribution. Important sampling is a simple extension of this equation. So the main idea is, instead of sampling directly from our target distribution pi of x, we're going to have a proposal distribution g of x. So when we sample x, the random variable x is going to be sampled from a proposal distribution g of x instead of the target. And then if we want to know the mean still from our target distribution, we can say that mu is going to be equal to the integral of h of x times pi of x dx. And we can say that that's equal to the integral of h of x times pi of x times g of x divided by g of x dx. Basically, we're just multiplying and dividing g of x. And when we do that, this is going to basically give us the expected value with respect to the proposal distribution g of h of x pi of x over g of x. So the reason we do this extra step in importance sampling of multiplying by g of x and dividing by g of x is because now we can use a sample from a different distribution to estimate the mean from the target distribution. And this is basically importance sampling in a nutshell. So this formula, if you know this, then you know enough to be able to write an importance sampling algorithm to estimate certain properties of a target distribution. And the reason you would do importance sampling, the reason you would do this step of creating a proposal distribution and sampling from that instead of your target distribution, could be a couple of reasons. One reason could be that the target distribution is hard to sample from directly. And another common reason of doing importance sampling Monte Carlo methods is variance reduction. You're going to see in the example that I'm going to do in a minute that when you do importance sampling instead of naive Monte Carlo, you're going to get an estimator that has smaller standard errors, and also sometimes it will be more accurate as well as the naive Monte Carlo method. So it's often used as a variance reduction technique as well. So in this video, I'm going to do this really simple example of importance sampling as a variance reduction technique. This is an example where you could use naive Monte Carlo, but I'm going to compare in R the naive Monte Carlo algorithm and the importance sampling algorithm and show that the importance sampling algorithm reduces the variance. So it's basically a better way of estimating the, in this case, expected value of the random variable. So this example says, suppose x is exponentially distributed with rate lambda is equal to 1, and you want to estimate the expected value of a function of x. So the function is e to the negative x plus cosine of x. We're going to do that two ways in the R code. We're going to use naive Monte Carlo, and we're going to also use importance sampling. So I have plotted here in the black line, we have h of x times pi of x. So our target distribution is exponential 1, and the h of x is e to the negative x plus cosine x. From naive Monte Carlo, we know that this expected value is equal to the integral of e to the negative x plus cosine x times the target distribution PDF. So that's just e to the negative x, because that's the PDF of exponential 1. So basically, we want to estimate the integral of this, which you could simplify that to be e to the negative 2x plus cosine x. So we want to estimate this integral. And I plotted h of x times pi of x here in the black line. If we just did naive Monte Carlo, we would be sampling from a repeated sample from the exponential 1 distribution, which is our target distribution. So I plotted here exponential 1 in pink. So this is exponential 1 from 0 to 2.5. So you could estimate the expected value of e to the negative x plus cosine x using just your target distribution, and that would be naive Monte Carlo. So in naive Monte Carlo, let's say you sample 10,000 samples from your target distribution, exponential 1, then you would just plug in those values of the sample into e to the negative x plus cosine x. So you plug in your sample where the x's are, then you could just take the sample mean of that, and I will show that in the R code, get an estimate of your expected value. That would be the naive Monte Carlo method. However, an alternative method would be to use importance sampling. So in importance sampling, here I have plotted exponential 2. So exponential 2 is the orange line, exponential 1 is the pink line. And if we compare this, which I'm going to say is g of x, our proposal distribution, the proposal distribution, if we sample from that and do importance sampling, it's going to give us a better estimate of the expected value, because if you look at the support of h of x, pi of x, which is what we want to estimate from, the orange line more closely follows the black line compared to the pink line. Because the orange line more closely follows the support of h of x, pi of x, it's going to give us a better estimator when we use Monte Carlo methods. So if you have a question of how do I find a good proposal distribution, you want to plot either in a graphing calculator or on a computer h of x, pi of x over the support of your target distribution, and you want to find a proposal distribution that closely follows the plotted line. So you want it to closely follow h of x, pi of x. So you can see that in the beginning, before the exponential decline, the orange line more closely follows the black line, and still here, when the orange line is above the black line, it's still closer than the pink line. So in both cases, when it's below the target distribution and when it's above the target distribution, the orange line is still better than the pink line. And another thing to note with importance sampling is that the orange line, so your proposal distribution, can go above and it can go below your black line. So that's okay either way. It's okay if it's not covering completely your distribution, and it's okay if it's above it as well. The main thing is you want to make sure that your proposal distribution has the same support as your target distribution. So exponential 1 goes from 0 to infinity, and the proposal distribution, exponential 2, will also go from 0 to infinity, so it has the same support. So it's a valid proposal distribution. So I'm going to do this example above in R, but to write out the algorithm using importance sampling is going to be, we want to draw IID samples x1 to some value xm, so that could be 100 samples, it could be 10,000 samples, just some number m from the proposal distribution g of x. Then we're going to calculate what are called important weights. So we want to calculate important weights, and the important weights are defined as wi, I'm going to call them w, is equal to pi x of I divided by g x of I. So for each random sample that we get in step 1, we're going to plug that into the target distribution and divide by the proposal distribution for each sample, and that's going to give us weights for every sample. And then finally, we just estimate the properties that we want. So if we want to estimate mu, we're going to estimate mu using the following formula. Mu hat is equal to, and then you're basically, for each sample, just going to multiply the weight by h of x. So we have the first weight multiplied by h of x1, and then after you multiply, we're going to add those all together. So the weights times the h function for each sample, and then you divide by the number of samples, and that would give your estimated mean of your target distribution. So then let's go ahead and do this example in R. Okay, so in this window, I have R opened up, and I'll try to put the sample code in the description box below. So the first lines of code just replot the graph that I showed. So we have the h of x times pi of x in the black line. We have our proposal distribution exponential 2 in orange, and then the target distribution in pink. So that's just redoing the plots. And then the first algorithm that I have is the importance sampling algorithm. So in this example, I'm going to start off by creating 1,000 IID random samples. So M is going to be 1,000 in this case. And then the first step is we want 1,000 IID random samples from our proposal distribution. That's going to be 1,000 draws from exponential 2. So I'm going to do that in this line of code. So after I run that, I have 1,000 samples from exponential 2. And then in this for loop, I'm going to create the important weights for each xi that I have. I'm going to plug that into the target distribution, which is exponential 1, and then divide that from the proposal distribution, which is exponential 2. After I run this line of code in the for loop, I'm going to have 1,000 weights. And then in the same line of code, I say to multiply each weight by h of x. In this example, h of x was e to the negative x plus cosine x. So I'm just creating the numerator for the estimate of mu that I want to have. And also before I run that for loop, I create an empty vector for each of the weights. And then I'm also creating an empty vector for the mu. Once that's created, I can run my for loop. And then all I have to do to estimate the mu is sum up all the values of my vector mu and divide them by m, the number of samples. So I can just do that by running mean of mu, and that will give me the sample mean. So when I run that, it's going to give me that the sample mean is 1.157226. So that's going to be the estimate of our expected value of h of x. So the expected value of e to the negative x plus cosine x when your target distribution is exponential 1. That's our important sample estimator. And also I got the standard error as well. So that's going to be the square root of the variance of mu divided by the sample size. And when I run that, our standard error is 0.008. As a reference, the integral that we're trying to estimate, our expected value, does not have a closed form solution, but I looked up the calculation in Wolfram Alpha, so approximately the correct answer should be 1.16. And so our estimator was 1.157, so we're in the ballpark. Using just 1,000 samples, that's not too bad. And then at the bottom for this line of code, I just want to compare the important sample method to the naive Monte Carlo method. So to do the naive Monte Carlo, it's a couple extra lines of code that's very simple to run. So naive Monte Carlo, we're going to sample directly from the target distribution. So our x is directly sampled from exponential 1. And then we just do the sample mean of h of x. And that would give us an estimator of 1.1437. And I also calculated the standard error. The standard error would be 0.027. So if the true answer should be approximately 1.16, our important sampling estimator was 1.157, and the naive Monte Carlo method gave us an estimator of 1.1437. So you can see that important sampling gave us a better estimator using 1,000 samples than the naive Monte Carlo method, and it also gave us variance reduction, like I said it would. So it gave us a smaller standard error by a lot compared to the naive Monte Carlo method. And you can compare this for different numbers of iterations as well. So if I change this to 10,000, then the estimator for the mean should get better. So you see it went from 1.157 to 1.160 using importance sampling. And the standard error gets smaller as well if you increase the sample size. And the naive Monte Carlo method also improves when you increase the number of iterations. So, and that's it for this video, and thank you guys for watching.